In this video, we will see the basics of logarithm. Theoretically, any number except 0 and unity can be taken as the base of logarithm, but in practice, all the logarithms are calculated to the base 10. These are called common logarithms. However, all power numbers are not integral powers of 10. For example, log 348 is equal to 2.5416. 348 cannot be expressed as an integer power of 10, but 348 is more than 100 and less than 1000. So the logarithm of 348 must be between lies 2 and 3. Here, the integral part of logarithm is called characteristics and the decimal part is called its mantissa. 2 is a characteristics. 0.5416 is a mantissa of a logarithm. Now let us see how to find the characteristics. The rule 1, if a number is greater than unity, the characteristics of logarithm is a positive integer and it is numerically 1 less than the total number of digits in the integer part of that number. 348 is a number greater than unity, therefore the characteristics of log is positive. Hence the characteristic is 2. For practice, refer table 2 when numbers are integers and when numbers are integers and fractions. Rule 2. If a number is lesser than unity, the characteristics of its logarithm is a negative integer and it is numerically 1 more than the number of ciphers immediately following the decimal point. For example, 0.459 is a number lesser than unity, therefore characteristics of its log is negative. Refer the table 3 when numbers are pure fraction. For example, 0.4589 is equal to 1 bar. Here number of cipher just after decimal point is 0. Second, log 0.428 is equal to 2 bar, number of ciphers just after decimal point is equal to 1, and so on. Table 3, when numbers are pure fraction, 10 raised to minus 1 is equal to 0.1, 10 raised to minus 2 0.01, 10 raised to minus 3 0.001, 10 raised to minus 4 0.0001, and so on. Here, rule 2 operates only when there are no digits before the decimal point. Now let us see how to find mantissa. The fractional part of logarithm is called mantissa. Mantissa of a logarithm can be ascertained from logarithm tables. The log of first 4 significant digits in which they occur should be taken, irrespective of the position of the decimal point. For example, find log 3074. Here, the number of digits in the given number is 4. Therefore, the characteristic is 3. Mantissa in the log of 307, refer the table 30 and column 7. It returns 4871 plus add mean difference for 4. Mean difference of 4 is 6. The total of mantissa of log 3074 is equal to 0.4877. Now let us see how to find the antilogarithm of a log values. Antilogarithm is the inverse function of logarithm. By referring previous example, say log 3074 is equal to 3.4877. 10 raised to 3.4877 is evaluated by referring the tables of antilogarithms. The rule is applied for antilogarithm is ignore the integral part of the characteristics of the log and use mantissa part only. For example, to finding the antilog of 3074, that it returns 3.4877. The antilog 0.487, it returns 3069. Plus mean difference for 7 is 5. The total of 0.4877 as found in the table is 3074. To conclude, Rule 2 operates only when there are no digits before the decimal point. But when a number has the integral part, the characteristic is determined by the number of digits before the decimal point, as per the rule 1. Thank you.